Hi guys, good evening. I hope I'm audible. Am I audible? Okay. Okay, great. I guess we won't be expecting more people today because the link has been changed, I believe, hai na? The link is changed now. You got the link, might be in the Discord channel and stuff. Good evening, Pujan. You got your links in the Discord channel? Or is the previous one from text message? Okay, got it. All right. Okay. All right. From text message. Got it. Chalo. Let's go around and do something today. We were working on React, I believe. Anna? We were working on React. Theek hai. Okay. So, before I actually go around and do something, if you have any doubts related to anything that we have covered out so far, feel free to push your doubts in the chat section. Or if you're good, we'll move ahead. If you have any doubts, then put the doubt in the chat section. Or else, give me a yes, we'll move ahead. We're working on the stars tracker, I believe. Okay. Other people? Waiting for everyone's confirmation and then we're going to move ahead. Huh? Other people? Are we good? Can we get a recap? Obviously, we'll get a recap. We're going to do... should we start talking about everything from starting? Because most probably, I believe only one functionality is left and we'll cover it out hardly like in 20-25 minutes. So that's not going to be... And most probably everything that you actually need to know about React for the basics part is almost done. So there is only one thing that I need to show you, which is like, is kind of going to be a little new for you, which is like copying the states. So that is something that I'll be teaching you today, that how you're going to go around and copy states in JSX. I believe that's the only part which is remaining out, and test, I believe, is almost done. So let's go around and talk about the whole application from the start. The recordings are there already uploaded. Amruta, you can go around and check. Recordings are, I believe, is up to date. Okay, so you can go around and check that out. So if you're ready, we can have a discussion from the very start where we actually started it from day one. And let's go around and talk about React in very general. And we are going to see if you actually remember all of these things. So shall we do that? Shall we do that? So you'll get a whole idea how this application is working as a whole sum. Right? Aaj kya hua? You do not feel so energetic today. All okay. Guys. Are we there? Are we on the same page? If you are like worried about something or all okay, na? Okay. All right. Chalo. So we started on with React. So we said that React is a front-end framework. And this framework is going to help you out in designing and layouting your whole web application. So React is a framework which is owned by Facebook. And this is managed by Facebook itself. And you'll generally will find out a lot of updates about React. When we talk about React, it is one of the most popular frameworks out there that you can actually go around and use. But for initially starting up with this, you actually need to understand the file system architecture of the same. So the file system architecture is like quite very simple. First of all, you actually need to go around and install Node. So when you install Node, you can create a React application by just writing npx create React app and whatever name that you want to keep. So the latest update says that you're not supposed to write anything capital in there, right? Everything is needed to be in the lowercase, right? So that's what we have done. We have created up this something called as Task Tracker app, and that's what we're building. Now, on the very first day, we had to look on that there is a main thing which is called as index.js, which we never generally touch. It's going to be the way it is. And there is nothing actually, you know, too much to know about this. The only thing that you need to know is there is something called as React DOM, which is a secondary DOM. And the main DOM that it has, it actually changes everything. And so what does this React DOM do? It takes in JSX and convert it, that JSX completely into plain JavaScript, right? And renders everything in the main DOM, which we have seen, which is called as document. Okay, and then it renders everything up. And the first thing that it renders is this app component. So we have talked that when we hear the word React, in React, everything and anything that we design is based on components, right? So what we do, we break the whole project into different components, different modules, and then we put on these modules together at one junction, which is called as app.js, because your index.js only knows how to render one component, which is the main root component, the parent component, which is this app component. So you could see that there is a file which is called as app.js. And in this app.js, you'll find generally any of the components that we'll be creating, we are going to import these components up and we are going to use these components, right? For example, if you'll see out here, we have a header component that we have kept out here. So this is the heading component. And then here you can see that we even have a task component that also we have kept it out here. So anything, if you want to make it global, you can, even if it's properties, even if it's states, even if it's components, everything that meets at a very junction is that junction is this app.js. So then what we did, we came around and we said that we are going to design the application in such a way that we are going to disintegrate this whole application into components. And the very first component that we had to look on was, I believe, this button.js, right? And if you'll have a look on this button.js, we didn't do any. Oh, first of all, we created header.js, if I'm not wrong. So in the header.js, what did we do? We created up this component. How do we create a component? We have two ways of creating a component. Either that component could be a class-based component, or that could be a function-based component. So what we are dealing with, as you can see out here, we are creating a function-based component. And in the function-based components, there is an extension which is available in the VS Code, wherein just all you need to write is RAFCE, and it's going to create the component, the function component for you, right? And in this function component, as you could see out here, we can create properties out here, we can define states, we can define pretty much anything that we want, right? And then what did we do? There is a method which is called as render method, and anything that you want to render inside it, you can render it inside this header, right? Or inside this component, right? So in turn, in this, you could see that we have a header component inside this. You could see that we have even created few functions. And then we started on to discuss that what is props, right? Now props is a way where you can create your components customizable. For example, if you'll have a look on app.js, you could see that while we were creating header component, we are passing few props that basically changes the utility, the application, the properties of that particular component. So while we were doing this title as a task tracker, you could see this title is needed to be grabbed by the component itself. So if you'll go to header.js, you'll find out that while we were creating this header, you'll see that we are destructuring this title, which is a prop, right? And in turn, this prop is being used out here in the H1. So all you need to do is just put the curly brackets on, and whatever you want to render inside it, you can do that, right? Similar is the case with button component as well. You could see that we are passing color as a prop, a text as a prop. And in turn, we could also pass an event as a prop. So you could see that we are passing a prop called as onClick, and we are passing this function as a prop, as an event prop. So once you'll go to this button.js component, you can see that alongside with color and text, we are also catering onto another prop, which is this onClick, which is a function. And you could see out here that we are calling this onClick component, which is a prop, on a different event, which is an on-click event. So when we click on this button, this is going to be passed as a prop and it would be gone, and this would execute this function, which is, where is it? Which is out here, this function, right? On-click function, which is going to say console log hello, right? So this is what we have done. Then we also talked about something called as default props. Default props are going to help you out to make your code more robust. If you're not passing any props, might be a situation that your component stops to, you know, work. So in that case, just to make your code more robust, you can add default props, right? While you're adding default props, you can also mention the types of the props which are going to be passed, and that's called as prop types, right? And you'll have to import these prop types, right? And you can use these prop types, something like this. So here you could see that while I was passing the title as a prop from app to header component, you could see that I said that whatever title component, which were title prop, which is going to be passed from app to header component, the type of this is going to be string, and this is required, right? So if it's not, it's just going to give you the error in console, right? Still going to render, but it's going to give you a good utility for debugging. Okay, so this is what we have done as of now, right? And then yesterday in the session, what we did was this part, right? And we said that we are going to do something like, we created up this task.js, and we said that we are going to disintegrate all of these tasks into individual tasks. And we created up this component called as task.js. In this task.js, again, we are doing the same thing. You could see that in the tasks, we are calling this component called as task, and we are passing few props. One is the key, which is like mandatory when you're passing something like of an array. In that case, you need to pass a unique ID to the same, right? And similarly, we are passing task as a prop, and this task is basically the map. It's the map of all of the tasks that we have. We are taking onto this task as a prop from app. So how is it happening? From app, what we are doing, I gave you an example, if you remember yesterday, from app, we are passing this state, which is this task state, which is these tasks. We are passing this as a prop to your tasks. As you can see out here, we are passing this tasks to your tasks, right? So in the task, you could see that I'm taking on two tasks. I'm going to loop around with the same, and whatever the individual task is going to be, I'm going to assign it to the task component. So at the task component here, you could see that I'm taking onto this prop, which is this task prop. And what I'm doing, I am going to mention out whatever the text of the task is going to be. And alongside with that, I'm going to put a cross sign so that I can go around and delete that up. So for delete, what I did for deletion, what I said that from this app, I'm going to create a function called as delete task. And this delete task is a function which is going to delete the task, right? So this is going to filter around with all the IDs that I have. And I'm going to say that whatever ID which is being clicked, only that is going to be removed, else all the other tasks are going to be shown, right? So in this case, I pass the prop, a functional prop or an event prop, which is this on delete. And I'm calling this as a function, which is this delete task. So if you'll just go to tasks, you could see that I'm passing a function, which is on delete. And again, this prop is being passed as a prop to task, right? And similarly, if you'll come to task, I'm going to destructure this on delete, and I'm going to mark that up on the click of the button, the X sign that I have. And on click of that, I'm going to execute this function, which is going to call this on delete and going to pass each and every ID. And this ID would now then reach to app.js. And this ID is going to destructure that and going to look that which of the tasks should stay, and which of the tasks should get removed, depending upon what is being clicked and what is not. So I believe till here, everybody is okay. If you have any doubts till here, just give me a yes or give me the doubt. Or if you're good, just give me a yes. We'll move ahead quickly. If you're good till here, just give me a yes. If you're not, just give me the doubt, or else give me a yes. Okay. So that's like nothing hard and fast that we have done. It's pretty simple. It's pretty normal stuff that we are doing. So let's actually take this localhost 2 Google Chrome. Okay, so this was the thing. Can you please repeat the filters part? Okay. So this delete, okay. So Pooja, I believe how this delete task is working, the working of this delete task is okay. The working, just the working, that how is this getting rendered from here to task.js? I believe that part is okay for you. Are we okay till there? So now if I go to task.js, so you could see out here what I'm doing. I, on the click of a button, I'm not directly calling this on delete function. You could see that I'm executing another function out here, and then I'm calling on delete. And once I'm calling this on delete, what I'm doing, every task which is coming from tasks, I'm going to extract each and every ID, and I'm going to pass this ID back to app.js, as you could see out here, because app.js would be needing the ID, which is getting passed from task to app, and this ID is getting passed on. So what would be the IDs that will be passed on? The IDs will be 1, 2, 3, right? The ID 1, ID 2, and ID 3. So are we good till here, Pooja? So task is passing an ID from task to tasks, and from tasks, it's coming to this app, right? So in here, the ID is going to be passed on, and this ID, we are going to say that which button was clicked. And for whatever button is going to be clicked, I'm going to remove that particular task. Else, all the tasks that would be there are going to stay. So that's what I'm saying all the tasks, and I'm going to filter from all the tasks to that particular task whose ID does not match on the click of a button. So only the buttons whose ID didn't match are going to stay, else all the tasks are going to be removed. So which task is going to be used? The task is going to be used is button is being clicked. So if I click this button, this filter is going to do what? It says the particular task on which the button was clicked, because you could see that on the task, I'm calling this function on click. So whatever button is going to be clicked, that ID is going to be passed from task to your app, and that ID is going to be here. And if that is the ID which the button was clicked, then that is going to be removed, right? That is going to go to this change task, which I believe you remember, that this would be used for any of the CRUD operations that you'd be doing, right? So on whatever button that I'm clicking, you could see that that's getting removed, right? And at the end, I created up this if else part, and I said, if the task.length is going to be greater than 0, then I am going to show the task, because the length is going to be 0. That means the tasks exist. And if there exists no task, I'm just going to say no task to delete. Make sense, Pooja? Make sense? I'll highly recommend for the people who are getting confused, you actually sit around with the same, open the video, sit along, and then go around and code it. Then you'll realize that everything seems to be fine. Until and unless you don't get your hands on onto React, I don't think that this React is going to, you know, make a lot of sense to you people. So keep that in mind. Okay? All right. So are we ready? Shall we move ahead? Okay, by the way, how many of you are very new? Because I'm seeing a lot of new faces. Chalo. How many of you are coming here for the very first time, by the way? Anyone here who's coming here for the very first time? Anyone? Everybody is here from the start, right? Chalo. So let's go ahead and let's do something. Okay. And what am I going to do? And the only functionality that is remaining out here is to add a task, right? So let's go around and create a new component. And in that component is going to be, responsible for adding a task to this DOM. Okay. So let's do that. So are you ready? Let's go around and add tasks. the only functionality which is removed, which is remaining. So what am I going to do? Let's go. So in the components, let's go around and create a new component, and let's call this component as, let's say, addTask.js. So this is the component that we'll be creating today, which is going to be addTasks. Again, it's a component. So I'm just going to say RAFCE. And this is the function-based component that I'm going to build today, right? Now in here, let's do one thing. Let's actually create a form, okay? So that you'll get an idea how to create a form in the, and that's what I thought for the very first day, but I'll be teaching you forms as well alongside with React. So let's go around and create a form, okay? It should be React JavaScript. JavaScript React. So let's go around and create form. So I'm just gonna say form. Ready? Form. Now this is going to be a form, just a normal form, right? And inside this normal form, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create three form elements, right? So let's not create the action as of now. What did you do just now? I just created up this function. Oh, sorry, this component, which is going to be this add task. That's all I did. No, changed. Oh, initially, now when you do this, you could see out here, this is a language mode in VS Code. So initially, when you open any React app, it's going to be selected as JavaScript by default. But you can actually change it back to React JavaScript or JavaScript React. So you can do that. So that's what I did, right? So nothing hard and fast. All right. So let's go around and create a form. And if you will have a look on the index.css, I have basically created a few stylings for your forms as well. So if you'll just come out here, you'll see that I have a form. And the class name is, I believe, add form. So if you could see out anything as add form, right? And same is for form control label, form control input, right? Form control checkboxes, and a lot of different things, right? So keep that in mind. I'll be using these classes. So out here in the form, I'm just going to give this a class name. And the class name here I'm going to give is add-form. Right. And inside this form, I'm going to create three different things. Right. What is this going to be? I'm going to actually go around and create, three divs inside it. So what are the divs that I'm going to create? Let's talk about that. So the very first div that I'm going to create is going to be of form control. Right. And in this, I'm going to create a label. And in this label, I am just going to call this as task, right? So this would be the task. And then I'm going to create a input type text. Oh, sorry. I'm just going to say input type text. So I'm just going to come out here and going to say type text, right? I don't want to give any name or ID. Or rather, I'm just going to give it a placeholder saying add task. All right. And then what am I going to do? What could be done? Chalo, let's do one thing. Let's go around and copy this out. I'm going to paste this in three times because I have three things out there, which is a task, the date and time, and whether it's been completed or not. So that is something that I'll have to look for. So I'm just gonna come out here. The task is the label, and in here it's going to be day and time. So rather, let's say day and time, type text, add day and time. Okay. And then later, what am I going to do? I am going to create something called as, let's say set reminder, maybe. Set reminder. And let's not create an input type text out here. Rather, let's go around and create, checkbox. I believe I've given, wait, let me be sure about this. I've created checkbox, right? So yeah, I've created checkbox. So in here, I'm just going to give the type as checkbox. So I would not be needing this placeholder. I'm gonna get rid of that placeholder. Okay. And at the end, let's go around and create a button. And in this case, the input type is going to be a button. And I'm going to give this a class. And the class name here, it's going to be button block. Okay. Now this is button block. And if I wait a second. So I have this label and the input type. And I didn't give the value, right? So let me give the value as well. So the value here is going to be, let's say, save task. Right? I guess this is fine. Yeah, one more thing. If you are creating checkbox, I am going to give this a class of form control check because it's a checkbox. All right. So I'm just going to save this. I'm going to go to my app.js. And just right after the header, I'm going to add this component, which is this add task component. And I'm going to import this quickly. I'm just going to go out here. So import this from components / items. So if I save this, you'll see a form, right? Now this form, it's pretty simple form. So it's just going to ask you if you want to add the task for whatever task that I hope there is no noise. Is there a lot of noise that is coming from my end? Is there a few noises which is coming out? No, I believe my voice is pretty audible, right? Okay. So you could see out here that I have a form and this form has a label of task. Oh, and then you have a day and time. And then you have a set reminder, which is basically a checkbox, right? And then you have a save task. Pretty cool stuff. Now, what is the point out here? The point is going to be very simple. That on the click of the button, what should I be able to do? The only thing that I should be able to do is that when once I click on this button, save task, whatever is the value which I have kept out here, which is going to be the value of this task and the value of this day and time, on the click of the save task should appear out here with a cross sign, right? That's the whole point that we'll be doing. For that, let's do one thing. Let's go back to add task and create or mention the states. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to add states to this add task, right? So what am I going to do? So I'm just going to get rid of this, or rather I'm going to import useState. So you remember useState, right? And this would be from React itself. Okay, so I am going to import this. And then in here, I'm going to add or mention the states of add task. Now keep that in mind, the states that I'm mentioning out here in the add task component, these states
are going to be in-house state. That means I am not going to expose these states to somewhere else. Rather, I'm going to use something completely different. And what is that going to be? We're going to talk about that in a little second. But what am I going to do? I'm going to add few states of add task. So I'm going to mention states of add task, and I'm going to manipulate these states within the component itself. So that's what I'm going to do. So what will I do? I'm going to create three states. What are these states going to be? One is going to be the text state, which is going to be for the task. The next thing, the next state that I'm going to create, that's going to be a day state. And the next thing or the next state that I'm going to create is going to be the reminder state, right? So let's go around and create them. So what am I going to do? I'm just going to say const. And the first state that I'm going to create is going to be called as text state. And in order to change or in order to manipulate the state, we are going to use something called as set text, right? This is the function. It's going to manipulate this state, which is this text state, right? And then I'm going to use the use state, right? And in this use state, I'm going to pass with something which is called as default properties or the default values of the of that particular state, which is this. Right, so this is what I've done. I've created const text, so it's giving me error because I might not have used it, right? Yeah, so the same thing, I'm just going to copy this out and going to create two more states. One is for day, the another one is for reminder. So this is going to be the day, and this is going to be called as set day, right? And because both are text, so I'm just going to keep this text. But at the last, if I talk about reminder, this is going to be called as set reminder. You can call it set reminder or change reminder or whatever you want. It's just the name of a function that completely depends on you. And then you are going to use this use state. Now, if you're talking about a checkbox, what is going to be the default value? If you just have a look on the form, what will be the default value of a reminder? As you could see, just have a look on the form. What's the default value of the reminder? What's the default value? Huh? The checkbox is by default checked or unchecked? It's unchecked, right? That means I am going to keep the default value of this checkbox to be a false. So keep that in mind. So why have I kept this as false? Because I am keeping the default value of this particular state, which is going to be this reminder state, I am going to keep the default value as to be false, right? Makes sense. So we have mentioned few states, and that's what we are doing. All right. Are we good till here? Quickly, if you're good, just give me a yes. We're gonna move ahead. All right. Now the next thing that I want you guys to introduce is to something called as extensions. So if you will have a look on extensions, I have an extension which is called as React Developers Tools extension, right? So you can just go around and search for React, or you'll have to actually go to the where do you need to go, by the way? I have not used Chrome for a really long time. Extensions, manage extensions. So it's just going to open out here. Where can I find all the extensions? Where do I search for extensions, by the way? I have no idea about it. So, open Chrome Web Store. Got it. So out here, you can just search for React Developers Tool. React Developer Tools. And you'll find this out here. And you can just go around and install this. You could see that it's already installed for me. So if it's not, I'll highly recommend you go around and install this. So this is going to make or whatever states that will be changing over. I'm just going to show it to you right now. You can actually look at the states which is being changed on runtime using these developers tool, right? So if you want the link, I'm just going to share you out with the link as well. You can have it in the chat section itself, Hannah. And I'll share you out with Discord as well. So I'm just going to copy this out and I'm just going to open Discord and I'm going to share you out with that as well.
My Discord was not on by default. Oh, just give me 1 second, huh? So in here, I am going to in the full stack to add this. Okay, so this is React Developers Tool. You can go around and install this app. I believe everybody got that, right? So you can just use these extensions. And how are we going to make use of these extensions is that if you'll actually come out here, you'll find out components. So you can come here in the component section. And you can actually could look that inside app, you have a header, and inside header, you have a button. And then you have add task, which is going to be in here. And then inside tasks, you can see that you even have keys equals to one, which I just said that each task should have a particular key ID, right? So this is the ID. And you could see key is equals to two, key is equals to three. You could see you have FA times, icon base, and different things like this. So you can actually can go around and do that. And the pretty cool stuff out here is going to be that if you go into this tasks, you can see the different props out here as well. You could see out here, you could see the props, what are the props, right? You could see all of these different things out here. So this is like pretty cool, pretty handy. If you're working as a React developer, you're going to make use of it a lot. Am I not audible? I'm audible, right? Yeah, okay. So in this case, this React Developers Tool is going to help you out at the case wherein, you know, you are designing a full-fledged application on the scene. So this is going to help you out a lot. And we are going to make use of it when we'll be doing a lot of stuff out here. All right. So are we good till here? Now, if you'll go to the console and save this, this is going to throw you some, this is going to throw you some errors because you have not used these functions, set text, set day and set reminders. So if you'll save this, you'll see that, you know, text is assigned but is never used, and you know, you'll get all of these warnings out down there. Okay, so now what we are going to do, what's the point? The point here is very, very simple. The point here is going to be that whatever that I'm going to write out here, whatever things that I'm going to write out here, my state should change. What is the state? The state here is going to be the text state, right? If let's suppose if you're working, open your ears and listen to me very carefully. I don't know why people tend to forget this. I think this is the one of the best things that you can make use of, you know, in React forms. If you're working on forms in React, this is the best functionality that I love about React. Is that you can actually manipulate your states. If you're working in your state itself, you can actually manipulate your states in React just by writing one of the attributes that JSX provides. And that attribute is called as value attribute. Now, let's say if I'm going to go out here and I'm going to write value, I can actually assign this value to this state, which is task state, which you are seeing out here, right? So in this case, what's going to happen, whatever changes that I'm going to make out here, whatever changes is going to be made out here, you are going to see these changes. And let me do one thing. I'm just going to put it right this way. I'm going to put a value, and then I'm going to put it in this way, right? Now, what you can do is you can put a value, and whatever changes that you'll be making out here will be reflected to your task. But there is a change that in this case, you have to cater onto a very little thing, which is called as on change. And on change is going to target onto the value of E, which is going to be the event parameter. And this is going to call the function of setText. And this is going to change the value to E.target.value. Why have I written a task? It's text, right? So what have we done? Just try to understand this part. This is the most important part inside the forms. What have I done? I have done is that whatever I'm going to write in my task, whatever things that I'm going to write in my task, I hope that you remember about this e.target.value at the time when I was teaching you
events in JavaScript. Do you remember about this? That once you're writing something in the form, you can actually pull the actual value that you have kept inside that form by targeting onto e.target.value. Do you remember? Do you remember or not? If you don't, I'm going to show it to you once more. Do you remember e.target.value? Guys, quickly, do you remember e.target.value? Be honest, if you don't, I'm going to show it to you again. But keep that in mind. What I'm doing, I'm grabbing the value and I'm putting this inside the state of text, whatever value that is going to be coming out here. And what I'm doing, that whatever changes which are being made, I'm making these changes appear inside the state. Because I told you, you cannot change the value of the state without using this function, which is going to be the setText. I hope this makes sense. I hope this makes sense to everyone. So if you'll save this, right? If you'll save this, refresh, you could see that only day and set day is not going to work. But if you'll just come out here at the React Developers tool and look at the components, and in this case, we are going to look at the add component. You could see that we have the first state, which is not being mentioned out here. But if you'll actually will write something out here, you'll see that that is getting changed. Can you see that? Can you see that? That on runtime, React is going to look onto all of these tasks and going to update the values automatically. So if, let's suppose if I'm going to keep it demo task, you could see that it's automatically, it's going to change the state. And you do not need to worry about how you're going to go around and change the state. I hope this makes sense to everyone, that what have I done in the code. So this is one of the most beautiful things that you can do in the forms using React, right? So the same thing, I'm also going to copy this out, or rather what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it in the next line and the placeholder in the next line. And then from here, what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy these both the values. Both the values that I have, I'm just going to copy this out and going to paste it out here. Now, in this case, the value of this particular stuff is going to be changed to the state that I have out here, which is this day state. So the day state should also change. And this should call the function of set day to event.target.value. Now, if you'll save this, refresh the page, and you'll see that even the day time would change. So if let's suppose if I say, what's the date today? What's the date today, by the way? Today's 1st May, right? Today's 1st May. Na? Let's say I say May 2nd, 2021 at, let's say, 8 p.m. So you could see that everything is getting changed on runtime in the state. And you could see that at task, I could just say demo task one. Right, so you could see that everything is changing at runtime. And you could see, because I kept the default value of this state reminder as false, it's not going to change until and unless I don't change it. Does this make sense? Everyone is okay with this? Anybody who has a problem with this? Anyone who has problem with this? Are we good? Are we good till here? Right? Now, the next thing that I'm going to do is to change the state property of the last value, which is going to be the reminder, right? So let's go around and change the reminders part. So in the reminder, what am I going to do is, so in the reminders, what I can do is reminders, ye set kar sakte hain. Let's see. So one thing though is going to be very sure, that we are going to change the value, and the value is going to change the reminder, right? So it's going to change the reminder state. And then now see, in the event, because it's a checkbox, right? So it won't have any e.target.value. So in this case, what we are going to do, we are going to say on change. We are going to keep this on change as the event parameter E, and this is going to toggle the value. How is it going to toggle the value? we are going to call set reminder, and inside this set reminder, we are going to keep the value as e dot current target dot checked, right? So if the button is clicked, it's going to change the value. Now let's go around and test this out. Now let's say if I have a demo task, so I'm just going to say demo task. Let's say May 2nd at 8 p.m. Now, if I check this, you'll see that it's going to be true. If I don't check it, it's going to be false. Can you see that? Can you see this? So you can actually change the values out here as well, right? You could see that the state is changing automatically, right? So let's keep it this way, right? So you could see the whole state is getting changed, and this is like really cool stuff. Now, the point here again is not still done. What we need to do, we need that on the click of the button, on, just listen to me very carefully, on the click of the button, the save task button, what should happen? I should be able, so now if I refresh the page, you'll see that I do not have any console errors. So that's gone because we have made use of all these states and all the functions of the state. So that's gone. But what do we want? We want that if we click on the button, for whatever button that I have, when I click onto that button, I should be able to see my whole state or the task, the day and the reminder in my console. That's the job that I want to do. Are we good? That what is the problem statement now? The problem statement is that whatever state that we just saw, whatever states that we had, or whatever we are going to be writing, on the click of the button, this save task button, I should be able to console log this in my console. That's what I want to do, right? So now for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go on my app.js, right? Because I'm going to add all the functionalities out here. So I'm going to go inside this app.js and I'm going to write the functionality to add the task, because at the end, the task should be coming here to this state, which is the task state, because it compiles of all the states, right? Because it's an array, right? And in order to change that, we'll have to use this function, which is change task. I believe you're getting the point. You're getting an idea. So from add task, whatever object that will be created for the task, for the day, and for the reminder should actually be thrown from app task to this app.js so that you can go around and append this up in this particular array. I hope this makes sense. Is this making sense? What I'm trying to explain you? Huh? Because what we are doing, we are adding this task from the add task component. We are creating the whole text day and reminder here as a state. So this is what I need to pass as an object from add task to this app.js. And how are we gonna do that? We're gonna have a look on that. But as of now, what I need is a function which is going to add the task. For as of now, I'm not gonna worry about the business logic, how am I going to display that. But as of now, let's keep this add task. And then I'm going to make this as a function, right? And inside this, I'm going to take task, right? The task. And in this case, I'm just going to say, console.log this task. Now, where is this task? We have no idea where is this task, right? We have no idea where is this task. We have no idea. So what we'll do, what we are going to do, we are going to throw this function add task as a prop to this add task. Because see, the inverse coming from add task to task is not possible. But going from app to add task is possible. I hope we have talked about this a couple of millions of times about this, that we can only go from app to any other component because we are calling all the other components from the app because that's the junction. But coming back from app.js to, coming back from add task to the app, that is not possible because other components are not calling app.js, rather app.js is calling all the other components. I hope this makes sense. Is this making sense what I'm trying to explain you? Yeah. So what am I going to do? This is the same thing that we have been doing for past 2 days. What I'm going to do, I'm going to pass this functionality add task as a prop to my add task component. So that's what I'm going to do. So you could see that what I'm going to do, I'm going to add this tasks. I'm going to pass this prop called as tasks from here And I'm going to pass this, and I'm just going to say that this tasks, or rather, let's say not tasks, rather, let's call it something else. Let's call this on add, right? And this on add is going to call this function, which is going to be this add task function, right? So the name of the prop here is on add, which I'm passing from app to add task. So I'm just going to go out here and I'm going to destructure that. And I'm going to say that I will get a prop called as on add, because that's what is being passed from app to add task. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to get this on add, and I'm going to do something with this on add. What I'm going to do is that, let's say we have a form here, right? This is a form. So I can just come out here and then say on submit, which is an event, and I'm going to call this function, which is going to be on submit. See, try and understand, huh? What I'm doing, I'm saying that the event on submit, when will this be fired? When we'll click on the submit button, because you could see that I've created up a submit button. Oh, I've created this input type button, right? Rather, let's do one thing. Let's make it input type submit rather. Right, so let's make this input type submit. So if we make this input type submit, the on submit is not defined, never mind. So this is going to stay here for a second, but on submit, because when the button is going to be clicked, because it's an input type submit. So what's going to happen, that this function would be called, right? So this is going to target onto on submit. So let's go and create this on submit. So what am I going to do? Let's do one thing. Let's go out here and create this function, and let's say const on submit. What I'm going to do, I am going to do a functionality, right? So what am I going to do? I'm going to pass it with an event parameter E. And let's go around and do some validation first, right? Let's go around and do some validation. So the on submit has not been, it's undefined, but all right, how could I show you that? So as of for now, let's cut this out, right? And save this so that I could just show you the app. So if you'll have a look on the, everyone can see this app. Everyone can see this app. So what am I going to do? I am adding few validation on the application. I'm going to add a validation, and the validation is like quite pretty simple, that if I'm not getting any task, right? That means if your user has kept this field empty, which is add task, though he has mentioned the date or time or not, I'm not worried about that. But if the user has not added any task, because if you remember, task.txt is what is being printed out here. So I just want that my user should always have to add this task, this add task wala stuff. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to come here. I'm just going to put it back. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to do a little bit of a form validation. And I'm just going to come here and I'm just going to say, first of all, what I will be doing, because on submit, if you remember in the HTML as well, I told you that every form has a habit of submitting itself to a backend. So first of all, we'll have to prevent the default. So first of all, do not let the form submit to the backend, because we have another functionality for the submit button. So we're just going to say E don't prevent default, prevent default. So the default behavior is going to be the same, that it's going to submit itself to a backend, but we don't have a backend. Rather, we are going to do the form validation itself. So I'm just going to come here and going to say, if the text, whatever text that I have, what is this text? This text is this text, right? It's a state of this particular value. So if the text is not available, that means if your user has not put any text out there, so what am I going to do? I'm just going to put an alert out here and I'm just going to say, please enter a valid task. Okay. So this would be alert.
and then I'm going to return from the function because I'm not allowed to do anything.
Then if the validation is done, then what am I going to do? I'm going to click onto onAdd. Now, what is this onAdd? This, if you remember, this onAdd is this, which is being passed from app to this task. So what am I going to do? I'm just going to say onAdd. And I'm going to pass few values to this onTask. So onAdd, what am I going to do? I'm going to pass the value of the text state, the day state, and the reminder state. Just try and understand what I'm trying to do out here, okay? So this onAdd, if you'll have a look out here, this onAdd is a prop which is making use of this add task. And what is this add task doing? It's taking the task. And where is this task coming from? Here is it's coming from. So it would contain an object which is going to contain the values of the text, day, and reminder, right? And then at the end, so I'm just going to comment this out, pass text, day, reminder object to display. Okay. And then at the end, I'm going to make my form back to default. And what is the default? The default is this default. I'm going to call set text, and the text should not be there in the form. Then I'm going to say set day, and I do not want anything in the form. And then what am I going to do is going to set reminder to false, which is the default values, right? So once you click on the submit, your form should disappear, right? All the values that you inputted in the form should disappear, right? So let's save this. And refresh. This should all be gone. Now, if I say demo task, let's say May 2nd, I'll just tell you, wait. But let me see if the code is working or not. May 2nd at, let's say, 9 p.m., if I say yes, set the reminder and save, you'll see that I'll get the text back. Can you see that? So I get the day, I get the reminder, and I get the text as well, right? Similarly, if I refresh this page and I'm going to save this task, you could see the form validation says, please enter a valid task, right? So even if I enter the task and save the value, still I'll get the value because that's what my validation is doing, right? Makes sense? So yeah, now ask your question. So Mandan said, what will be the ID for this, sir? So there is no ID. We are going to create the ID. But as of for now, there is no ID. That we'll see when we'll be creating this function. As of for now, when we'll be creating this function, add task, because this add task is not doing anything as of for now. Remember, this is just console logging this, right? So in the add task, what I did, I just came here and I took this value as on add. And pass the object of the state, which is going to be text, day, and reminder. And then I cleared up my form and said set reminder to false and all the values to null. I hope this makes sense to everyone. So on the click of a button, now you can see that I'm getting the values of the task, values of the day and time, and value of the set reminder as well. So we're good with this. The only part that is remaining is to display that. Guys, are we good? If you have anything to ask, please ask, but go through this code once, and then we're going to move ahead. Once you'll say yes, everyone will say yes, then we're going to move ahead. Quickly, other people, are we good? Are we good? Pakka, are we good? Hana? So let's move ahead. Now, what we are doing, we are just console logging this, if you remember. What we are doing on the click of a button, we are just console logging the values. But rather than console logging the values, we are supposed to do something. And what we are supposed to do something is to add these values, the value of the task which is coming, which we are passing from this add task. As you could see, that I'm passing the values of text, day, and reminder from add task to this app.js. Now, once I have this task, what I need to do is to put the value, right? So let's do one thing. Chalo, theek hai. Let's do one thing. I'm doing console log task, right? Chalo, pehle to ID bana lete hain fatafat se, hai na? Because if you remember, if you'll see out here that every of the state that you're going to pass, right? Because again, it's going to become the state of the app, right? Do you remember? Whatever task that we are going to add from add task to app, it's going to become a state and you'd need an ID. We do not have an ID as of now, right? So if you'll see out here to this components and inside this add task components, or rather in the tasks component, you'll see that all the tasks that I have, they have a dedicated ID for the same. Can you see that? We have an ID, we have a reminder, we have a text, and then we have a day. So we have the reminder, we have the text, we have the day, but we don't have an ID. So first thing first, what we're going to do, we are going to make an ID for the new text which is going to arrive, right? For that, we need an ID, because you remember that if you don't pass an ID, what's going to happen? That your console will start to throw you an error and stuff like that. So for that, I'm just going to come out here. I'm just going to say const ID. First of all, I'm just going to create an ID. I'm just going to comment this out so that if you look at the code, you'll realize what I'm doing. So create a new ID for the new task, right? So I'm just going to come out here. I'm just going to say const ID. Now, what can we do here? How should I give an ID? Yeah, let's do one thing. Let's use random numbers, right? That nobody asked you that you have to be very perfectly aligned at 1, 2, 3, 4. It should be any random ID, right? It should be a unique random ID, right? So that is something that we can do. Huh? So let's create a random number, right? Let's create a unique random number and decide on with the same. So let's go around and say math.random. And this math.random function, what I'm going to do, I am going to, let's say if I'm going to add, let's suppose I'm only going to add 1,000 values, right? So what I can do, I can make a floor of the same. So I'm just going to say math.floor, then I'm just going to put in 1. So now if I just come here and say console log, right, ID, so save. Now every time I'll click the button, right, so if I click the button, you'll see a random ID coming here, and if I click again, you'll see another random ID. If you'll click here, you'll see another random ID. But these, all of these random IDs are going to be falling from 1 to 1,000, right? So that's what I've done. So this is pretty cool. So we have created IDs now. Let's go around and do something then. So once we have an ID, what we are going to do, we are going to create something called as new task, because we are going to append the value as well. So in, yeah, this is important because you might see a lot of developers doing this. And even I use it a lot, right? So what do we have? We have a task, right? And we want to create an object, a new object. Initially, we created out here. We created up an object out here. If you remember, we created an object and passed it to onAdd, which came out here as a task, right? Now, what do we want? We want to create a new object. So in order to create a new object where ID should be a part, what I'm going to do, I am going to do is going to put an ID, then going to put a comma, and then I'm going to copy the whole stuff from this task and going to put it inside this object. So JSX can actually help you out in doing the same. If you put 3 dots in front of it and then you say task. So what it's going to do, it's going to copy all the values from this task, which is an object, and going to put all the values of task in here. So if you put 3 dots in front of any object and enclose it inside the object, so all the values of this object will now be a part of this object as well. I hope this makes sense. I hope, what is this triple dot is going to do for you? This triple dot. So this task which was being passed from here, which was this text day and reminder, You passed it to app.js, which came in here, and you copied it to here and added ID as well and created up a new object and said that this new object is going to be this new task. So if you want to just go around and say console.log, let's say new task, you can actually can do that, right? So let's see. So if I'll save this, come here, and I'm just going to say, let's say demo task, let's say demo day, you just set this reminder and click, you'll see that now you'll get an ID, a reminder, a text, and a day. Make sense? Make sense? Are we good till here? So we created up a new ID, and then we created up a new container or a new object inside which there is a new ID. Now we are ready to get these tasks. Are we good? Are we good? Guys, are we good? Are yes or no? I hope these three dots make sense to everyone, right? Now what will I do? Because now I have this new task. What am I going to do? I have to append this new task, and this is very important. A lot of people get confused with this, but this is the most important part and the most important thing that you need to understand what I'm going to do. This is a new task, right? This is a new task. And I want to make, or I want to add this task inside this state task. So what should I do? What should I do? I will have to use a function. Which function should I use? Anyone? Which function should I use? If I want to make any CRUD operations on the task, no, Abhilash, no. This is a state. How do you change and manipulate a state? Task is a state. I want to add this new task to this tasks. How should I add it? I told you that if you want to make any CRUD operations on a task or on state, which function should I use? Anyone? Which function should I use? The change state, the change task function. Keep that in mind. So this change task function is the only function which can help you in changing any of the CRUD operations or applying any CRUD operations. So what am I going to do? I'm simply going to come here and I'm going to add the new task to the state tasks. So in the task states, I'm going to add this new task. And how am I going to do that? I'm just going to call this change task. And inside this, I'm going to create an array. Now see, I'm going to create an array and I'm going to pass the already existing tasks that I had already, which is a state. And I'm then going to add the new task, which I created out here. Make sense? Does this make sense that what did I do? So I copied the whole tasks, which was this tasks, right? Which was the state. And then I also added this new task and created up a new array and said, now this is going to change the state of the task because change task is going to change my state. Make sense? Does this make sense quickly? Yes or no? Does this whole thing make sense? So now if I'll save this, now you'll see our application is complete, right? So you could see out here, if I'm saying demo task, let's say May 2nd at 8 p.m. And if I save this task, you can see that I have this task now, right? Similarly, I can just come here and say demo task 2. I'm just going to say that this is going to be on May 2nd at, let's say, 1 p.m. And if I save this and save this task, see that this is right. What should I repeat? What should I repeat? Tell me. Tell me. What should I repeat? What should I repeat? From creating a new ID. Okay. So see, everyone, again, just pay attention. So what we did, we called on to this add task. And what we did, this add task was passing the value of the states, which states text state, day state, and reminder state. And all of these values were passed onto this add on add, which was basically a prop. So this value got passed in here, and this was captured by our add task. And then this was a task which came around with here, right? Now, if you'll reload this, and if you'll go back, and if you'll see any of the previous tasks out here, Twinkle, can you see that I am passing the value of text, day, and reminder, but the only property that I don't have is an ID. Do you agree with this point that I do not have an ID? So what will I do? I'll create a new ID for the new task, because a new task is coming from add task to this. So this is the new task. So for this, first of all, I'll have to create an ID. So what am I going to do? I'm going to create an ID, and I'm going to assign a random number ranging from 1 to 1000. Okay. From 1 to 1000, I'm going to create a random number, right? And then I'm going to assign this new task, and I'm going to add this ID property with whatever task that is coming from add task to app. I'm going to copy that whole task, and I'm going to create an ID for the same as well, right? An ID with a task. So now what do we have? We have a text, a day, a reminder, and also now I have an ID for the same, right? And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to pick this new task, and I'm going to append it along with the task state that I had. So I'm going to copy the whole tasks, and I'm going to add this new state or the new task, and I'm going to call this function, which is this change task. That is the only function which is going to help you in the CRUD operations. It would allow you to do all the CRUD operations. And here you could see that I am able to add the tasks out here. See, so if you'll see demo task, and let's say June 1st, 2021 at 11 p.m. let's say, or 11 a.m. If you'll take this, save, you can see that I have a demo task. Make sense? Everyone, if you're good till here, just give me a big yes, so that I could understand that this whole task tracker application makes sense to everyone. And you can actually go around and delete all of these things, right? And you'll see that there are no tasks to delete. Okay. How was the application? Was it good? Did you understand everything? Did you understand each and everything? Right. So how is React? Is React easy, or is it difficult? Now tell me, how is React? Is it difficult, or is it easy? Batao. In between. No, it's not like that. You're a good student, actually. So git commit, add task functionality. Yeah, you actually need a lot of practice, guys. Anna? You should find it easy, Anna. I'm just going to say git push. You'll have to practice. See, practice is something that coding is only going to come from practice. The more you're going to practice, the more you are going to be a pro. Anna? Don't be a noob, be a pro. Anna? So oh no, this is not the one. So where do I have the app along? React constraint. So I believe I have a source. So I'm going to take the session on Angular as well. I'll see. I'm not sure. I might. No. change task is also used for deletion as well. As you'll see out here, as you can see, if you'll go to app.js, out here, you'll see that even for the deletion, you'll see that I'm going to use this change task. So any of the CRUD operations, Twinkle, that you will be doing, any CRUD operation, either you're deleting, you're adding, or maybe you're updating something, any of the CRUD operations that you'll be doing is going to be done with the help of only this and only this function, right? So this is why we call states are immutable, and they are only going to be changed by only standalone one function, that is going to be this. And you could also can see out here that if you'll realize that if you'll go to the components and if you'll go to this add task component, you'll see that even if I was changing, I'll see if I could teach you Angular, I'll see. I will discuss about that. When Angular is pretty like, it's almost the same, but like the concept is like, the whole idea is the same. It's also component based, but the whole coding part is like a little different, right? So even here you can see that when I was changing, you could see that on change, I was again calling the same method of the state, because again, this is a state, right? This is a state of add task. So if I want to change the state, Twinkle, I'll have to call the associated method. So if I want to change the text, I'll call setText. If I want to change the day, I'll call setDay. If I want to change the reminder, I'll call setReminder, because all of these three things are nothing but states. So keep that in mind. So are we good till here? Nobody has started this up. I believe you're not looking into all of these code and stuff. Okay. So if you want, you can go around and look into the code if you want. Okay, I'm passing you on with the code. And I'm also going to share the same link on Discord as well, right? So with this, our whole application of task tracker is done. Okay. And that's it for React. So how many of you actually learned something out of React? Be honest. How many of you now actually feel comfortable that, yeah, we can do something on React? If somebody asks me to create a portfolio, I will be able to say that, yeah, I know React. Okay. But again, the point is, go through these videos back, and I'll highly will recommend that if you'll be having any doubts, don't feel shy, don't feel afraid. I'm just a friend of yours, nothing hard and fast. I'm not your regular teacher. I'm not your instructor. I'm nobody. I'm just a friend. I'm just helping you out. That's it. Right. So if you ever get stuck anywhere, guys, feel free to push your doubts anytime on either on Slack. You even have my Instagram. What else do you need? Anna? So you can even push, you know, your doubts on Instagram. Even few of the students too ask their doubts on Instagram. So that's really fine. And I even respond them back. So it's not like, you know, I don't respond back. I just say or something like that. So you can actually can, you know, go around and push your doubts even on, Instagram as well. Bilkul, karni to padegi Nikhil, varna aise to nahi chalega, hai na? Because the more you're going to see, coding is all about practice. Are you on Slack? I'm definitely on Slack. I'm everywhere. You'll find me everywhere. I'm on Twitter, Instagram, Slack, Discord, anywhere that you want. I'm everywhere and anywhere. Omnipresent guy. Omnipresent only online, not offline. Because I'm a home alone kind of guy. And I don't go out. Yeah. So that's the case. So we're good. Any questions that you want to ask? Anything? Because this is going to be the last session for us. I have no idea when we're going to meet again. But yeah, that's the whole thing. So if you have any doubts, feel free to ask your doubts. And if you're good, just give me a yes. We'll end up with the session. See, I'll tell you, Angular and React are the two very frameworks that are like they have typically captured 97% to 98%, right? So that is like the two very, very important, frameworks that is like booming in the industry right now. But again, completely depends on you. Either you want to be a React developer, you can go around and get your hands dirty in both the frameworks. So that's fine. When it comes to backend, I highly will recommend either you learn React or either you learn Node. By the way, how many of you were in the morning session as well? Did somebody attend my morning session? Oh, Twinkle. Oh, okay, yeah. Few people were there. It was like something, yeah, it was like something related to Twitter stuff. So it's fine. It's fine. So I was just like taking a session on Twitter streaming API. We just streamed few live API, was live tweets and stuff. It's like nonsense, nothing happened. So either you can actually get, I basically introduced few people to Node. So Node is also like completely based on Java. Even for the people who might have seen me code, you might have seen that I was completely writing JavaScript. Have you seen that? So if you'll go with Node, even for a backend, you'll not find any difference writing JavaScript or writing any code for Node. People, if you were there, did you find any changes in the code? You might have figured that out, that he's just writing JavaScript, right? So there's nothing hard and fast. So if that's why I'm saying, if you're good with JavaScript, you're pretty much good with front end. You're pretty much good with back end as well, right? And you're pretty good with React as well, for that matter. So I highly will recommend you go around and brush your skills on JavaScript. That's like most important. And if you're good with JavaScript, you'll be able to crack any of the front end, any of the back end, anything that you want, that you'll be good with that. Okay. So that's the case. So any other doubts? Any other doubts? If you don't have a doubt, just give me a big yes. We can end up with the session then. If you don't have doubts, just give me a big, big yes and we'll end up with the session. Great. Great. So guys, this is going to be the journey then. Lovely having you people on board. I had an awesome time teaching you people, training you people. And thanks for being good friends, right? And most probably we'll meet up soon. If we'd be having something that would be coming up, maybe on backend or maybe on any of the, frameworks, we'll let you know. Hana? And if you'd be interested, you can join along. All right. So thank you so much. Thank you so much, Nikhil. So be in touch. Yeah, be in touch. And I'll be really happy seeing my students going. Hey, sir.